At 10:48 p.m. local time on October 27th, the ground began to rapidly shake back and forth in the town of Sindirgi in Turkey, causing some people to panic. A strong earthquake had just struck at shallow depths with an epicenter 4.6 kilometers east of the aforementioned city with a population of 14,000, registering in as a magnitude 6.0. Across the next 15 seconds, items fell off of shelves, cracks formed in the walls of a few structures, and half a dozen structures completely collapsed, with others suffering partial collapses, including at a few multi-story buildings. The simulation you are seeing in the background shows the reported peak intensity shaking the earthquake produced, specifically MMI-8 intensity shaking within the settlement of Persunlar, forgive my probable incorrect pronunciation. This injured more than 5 dozen people and caused at least $2 million equivalent in damage. Yet, not only does this figure not include any deaths, but so far no one, to the best of my knowledge, is trapped by collapsed structures, and the actual damage and casualties which occurred was far lower than what the US Geological Survey model expected. But why might this be the case? As strange as this sounds, no deaths occurred from this quake because of a destructive, separate magnitude 6.1 earthquake which struck about 24 kilometers to the northwest on August 10, 2025. While that earlier quake did result in a single fatality, it damaged a number of structures, many of which, in my opinion, were already at a higher risk of potentially severe earthquake damage were a strong earthquake to strike. As a result, multiple structures were declared unsafe and abandoned, and it just so happens that the vast majority of structures which did end up collapsing on October 27th happened to be one of those abandoned structures. Thus, no lives were lost. This might not have been the case if the August 10th quake hadn't happened. So, why did this earthquake occur in the first place? While the August 10th quake involved a normal fault, the October 27th quake involved the motion of a largely right lateral strike slip fault with an oblique portion to it. In other words, around a 10-kilometer or 6.2-mile-long stretch of a lengthy fault line known as the Semi Fault Zone slipped. And the reason why this fault line exists relates to a tectonic collision offshore of southern Greece. There, the African plate is subducting underneath the Aegean plate. In the mantle, this tectonic plate extends all the way beneath western Turkey, albeit at incredibly deep depths. However, this subducted slab has been undergoing the process of slab rollback, where it is being slowly pulled down into the mantle at a steeper angle. As a result, hot material in the mantle is pulled upwards to fill the space where the aforementioned slab used to be, then going on to rise beneath the crust of western Turkey. This material has then spread apart to the northeast and southwest, generating a slow extension of the crust above it in those directions. While this motion is largely accommodated via the motion of normal faults, it can also be partially accommodated by strike slip faults, as was the case on October 27, 2025. So far, 7 magnitude 4 range aftershocks have struck following the 6.0 earthquake, the largest of which was a magnitude 4.9. The average rate of aftershocks should continue to decrease, in my opinion, as the time since the main shock quake increases. While some liquefaction and landslides were modeled to have potentially occurred, I have yet been unable to confirm that either actually did happen. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, Deanna Moore, for supporting my work.